Now is the time to wake from sleep. Salvation is close at hand. Moving from night into day, lift up your voices and pray. Come, Lord, Maranatha, come and bring us your peace. Come, Lord, Maranatha, come to us, set us free. Come, Lord, and bring us your peace. Cast off the deeds of the dark. Put on the armor of light. Turn to the source of the day, lift up your voices and pray. Come, Lord, Maranatha, come and bring us your peace. Come, Lord, Maranatha, come to us, set us free. Come, Lord, and bring us your peace.
To you I lift up my soul, O my God. In you I have trusted. Let me not be put to shame, nor let my enemies exult over me, and let none who hope in you be put to shame.
And let none who hope in you be put to shame.
Let us pray. Lord our God, we praise you for your Son, Jesus Christ. He is Emmanuel, the hope of the peoples. He is the wisdom that teaches and guides us. He is the Savior of every nation. Lord God, let your blessing come upon us as we light the candle of this wreath. May the wreath and its light be a sign of Christ's promise to bring your reign to the world. May we grow as disciples, faithful to your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Constantly watch, stay awake. No one can know the time, whether at dusk or at dawn, we sing this prayer and song. Come, Lord, Maranatha, come and bring us your peace. Come, Lord, Maranatha, come to us, set us free. Come, Lord, and bring us your peace.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning again. Welcome as we begin this Advent journey together. We come here each week to this sacred space to worship our God, to encounter Jesus in the most beautiful way, in his word, and most especially in his sacrament in the Eucharist. And we also encounter him in one another, where two or three gathered in his name, he's certainly there in our midst. So let's now welcome one another and the Christ that's in each of us.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie.
Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and Judah. In those days, in that time, I will raise up for David a just shoot. He shall do what is right and just in the land. In those days, Judah shall be safe, and Jerusalem shall dwell secure. This is what they shall call her, the Lord our justice.
The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. To you, O Lord, I lift my make known to me. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me. For you are God, my Savior. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice and teaches the humble his way. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. All the paths of the Lord are the kindness and constancy toward those who keep his covenant and his decrees. The friendship of the Lord is with those who fear him, and his covenant for their instruction. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we have for you, so as to strengthen your hearts, to be blameless in holiness before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his holy ones. Amen. Finally, brothers and sisters, we earnestly ask and exhort you in the Lord Jesus that, as you received from us, how you should conduct yourselves to please God, and as you are conducting yourselves, you do so even more. For you know what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus.
The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars, and on earth nations will be in dismay, perplexed by the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will die of fright in anticipation of what is coming upon the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. But when these signs begin to happen, stand erect and raise your heads, because your redemption is at hand. Beware that your hearts do not become drowsy from carousing and drunkenness and the anxieties of daily life, and that they catch you by surprise like a trap. For that day will assault everyone who lives on the face of the earth. Be vigilant at all times, and pray that you have the strength to escape the tribulations that are imminent, and to stand before the Son of Man. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Recommit ourselves to the Lord. Well, today is the first Sunday of Advent, and a new liturgical year begins. And as we listen to the readings today, there was a sense of urgency in them, especially in the Gospel. Sacred Scripture is exhorting us to be alert and to look anew at our lives. This season of Advent is a great time to reflect on the year gone by and to set some spiritual goals for the year ahead. So today I'd like to offer three ways we can consider committing ourselves anew to being great disciples of Jesus Christ. Our first love. Earlier this month, I had the good fortune of listening to a priest from our diocese who was speaking to a group of Catholic medical professionals. And early in the presentation, he asked those in attendance this intriguing question: why did you choose to do what you are doing? The priest let that sink in for a few seconds and then began offering a list of possibilities: financial reward, prestige, an interest in the science of the human body, rapidly changing technology, the ability to enjoy a good standard of living, to name some. And then he went on for a little bit and started bringing up some of the drawbacks of the medical profession: many years of schooling, huge college debts, long hours, cranky and/or unmotivated patients, dotting all the I's and crossing all the T's of the administrative duties of the medical profession. And then he asked again, so why did you choose to do what you are doing? And without skipping a beat, he gave the following answer: I think most of you entered the medical profession because you like people and want to help them. The priest went on to describe this caring for and helping others as their first love, the heart of their vocation. The priest reminded those professionals that when they get all caught up in the benefits or the drawbacks of their occupation, their job can become a drudgery. He challenged them to always keep the people at mind as the first love of their profession, that when they do, their jobs will be fulfilling beyond all measure. So it is with you and me. In life, we can become numbed by the ordinary nature of our daily routines, and then we can get crabby about those little curveballs that life throws at us. Our tendency is to look at the obstacles we face, the state of the world, and often the chaos in our lives. And sometimes desperation can set in. Instead, just like those medical professionals, we have to remember our first love. So I ask you, members of Most Blessed Sacrament and guests, both young and older, no matter where life has led you to this point, what or who is your first love? What are the top one or two most important things in our lives that we perhaps have lost sight of? Could be our family, our marriage, our children or parents, our friends, our faith. This Advent is a time to rediscover our first love and rekindle the flame of those most important things. Then the words of today's second reading will run true in our hearts. May the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all. When we rediscover our first loves, it will be a springboard to recommitting ourselves to God. Our first responsibility. Let's go back to that presentation that the priest gave to those medical professionals. After his talk went on for a while, he asked a second question. What is your first responsibility as Catholics in the field of medicine? This one he answered immediately, to get your patients and co-workers to heaven. Now it's fair to say that he caught them off guard with that first question about why they chose their profession. But now you could feel the uneasiness in the room, the curiosity about this first responsibility of getting their patients and co-workers to heaven. That's because that's about as countercultural as you can get, our Catholic faith mixing with medicine. The priest assured them that they were in a unique place to see Christ in their patients, and that their patients could and should see Christ in them. And again, the priest's words struck a chord with me in regards to you and I. It's also our first responsibility to get the people we encounter in our daily lives to heaven. The gospel today reminds us to stand erect and raise our heads because our redemption is at hand. We stand erect in this life by letting others know their redemption is at hand as well. Listen to these words from the rite of our baptism. As Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so may you live always as a member of his body, sharing everlasting life. This living always as a member of Christ's body is to carry on Christ's mission. Number 1268 of the Catechism of the Catholic Church also reminds us of our role in this mission. It says, by baptism, we share in the priesthood of Christ in his prophetic and royal mission. My fellow Catholics, this royal mission, our first responsibility, is to lead others to Jesus through his mission of salvation. So as we consider recommitting our lives to the Lord, I leave you with two questions in this regard. If each of us were to step it up a notch in the coming year and became diligent about getting the people we meet in our lives to heaven, how would their lives change? And as important, how would our lives change? Our first Holy Communion. My friends, the third way we can recommit to the Lord in the coming year is through the renewal of our reception of Jesus in the Holy Eucharist. There is no better place to nurture our relationship with the Lord than when we receive the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus. For those of you who have received your first communion, I'd ask you to think back to that very special day. If you're anything like me, I was a young boy. Granted, I didn't know exactly what was going on, but I did know it was a big day, a day that something amazing was about to happen. So for those of us who come to this Eucharistic table every week or even every day, and we've been coming for many years, my question is this. Is receiving Holy Communion still a big day for us? Is it still amazing? Just like the medical professionals, when we get dragged down by the trappings of everyday life, we can lose sight of the most important thing. In our relationship with God, there is nothing more important, nothing more personal, nothing more intimate than the Holy Eucharist. As we begin this season of Advent and set forth to recommit ourselves to the Lord, let's transform our reception of Holy Communion. May we always come to this Eucharistic banquet with the wide-eyed wonder of our first Holy Communion. So, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, listen again to the end of today's gospel. Be vigilant at all times and pray that you have the strength to escape the tribulations that are imminent and to stand before the Son of Man. One day, each of us here will stand before the Son of Man. That is our destiny. In order to be ready, we need to be vigilant in recommitting our lives to the Lord in the coming year. Let's try to rediscover the first loves in our life, those one or two things that are truly important. Let's focus on helping our fellow brothers and sisters walk on a path toward heaven. And let's make every Eucharist a new and amazing Eucharist. In this coming year, let us recommit our lives and dare to be great for God.
We now stand and profess our faith together as we say, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all visible and invisible. Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I ask one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We make known our needs to God so that we can be vigilant and respond to Christ coming among us. Our response is, come and stay with us, Lord. Come and stay with us, Lord.
For the church, as we begin Advent, may we be alert and awake, ready to receive the Lord when he comes in his glory. We pray, come
and stay with us, Lord.
For world leaders, may a true and lasting peace cover the face of the earth. We pray,
come and stay with us, Lord.
For those who struggle daily to obtain food or shelter, may their needs be cared for by those who witness to the gospel. We pray,
come and stay with us, Lord.
For our faith community, May we be watchful this Advent season for opportunities to deepen our relationship with Jesus through prayer. We pray,
come and stay with us, Lord.
For Trinity Rose Bauer, who was baptized this week, may she, with the support of her godparents and family, always follow the light of Christ. We pray,
come and stay with us, Lord.
For the members of Most Blessed Sacrament Parish, in particular for the Nemchek family, for intentions in our prayer books, our books of the dead, and on our prayer line, and for our personal intentions. We pray,
come and stay with us, Lord.
For those who have died, in particular, we pray for Lori Eichstadt and James Nofke. May they look upon the face of God in heaven. We pray,
come and stay with us, Lord. O powerful God, your Son will come with great glory and power to gather us into your loving embrace. Hear these, our prayers, that we may be ready for his coming. We ask this through that same Christ, our Lord. Amen. Unto you, O Lord, have I lifted up my soul. O my God, I trust in you. Let me not be put to shame. Do not allow my enemies to laugh at me, for none of those who are awaiting you will be disappointed. For none of those who are awaiting you will be disappointed.
Beyond the sun and stars, as deep as night, so great our hunger, Lord, to see your light. The sparrow finds a see your light. The sparrow finds a home beneath your wing. So may we come to rest where angels sing.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us. And may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed, at his first coming, the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Sanctus,
Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis in celia terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and David our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command and form of divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Agnus Dei,
qui tollis peccatam mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccatam mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, Ata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Lord Jesus. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. The Lord will bestow his bounty, and our earth shall yield its increase, and our earth shall yield its increase.
Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people, light for the world to see. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine.
Longing for hope, many despair.
Christ be our light. Shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light. Shine in your church, gather today. Longing for food, many are hungry. Longing for water, many still thirst. Make us your bread, broken for others, shared until all are fed. Christ be shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gather today. Longing for shelter, many are homeless. Longing for warmth, many are cold. Make us your building, sheltering others, walls made of living stone. Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gathered
please be seated. Prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray.
For even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Again, for those of you who will be receiving the anointing of the sick, as soon as I'm down here in front, turned around facing you, you may start, those of you receiving may come forward. Just remember to put your palms out like that for the anointing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow down for the blessing.
May the Almighty and merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son, and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent and enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
As you run the race of this present life, may he make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity.
Amen.
So that rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.